What is good, guys? We are back with more World Cup action. We got out of League was the Eternal Spirit. League brought a Mega Zard team. Oh, they're both of Zard. Never mind. I assume it's gonna be Avi Majorna on Eternal's team. And then I could see Specs, Azimuth, Gengar. Yeah, I could see Specs, Gengar, Scarf, Latios, Azimuth, Landorus. That's an option. Got that Young Wish Pass, Alomar, Molar on deck. What else? Is it Zard X or Y? Let me try to figure that out. Why is there a World Cup game going on but no one is talking about it in the chat? That's so weird. But the Isle of League is on Canada and Eternal Spirit is, I think, on Brazil. And I assume it's gonna be Zard Y on League's team. I'm trying to see if he's offensive Celeste Dealer or Z-move. Defensive or Z-move Celeste Dealer is what I meant to say. I could see Z-move Celeste Dealer and Subtoxic Tren. But yeah, switching out there means he probably doesn't have... Like, he either predicted the Latios. Or he's Zard X. That's all the options. Zard X with Misty Terrain is interesting, so Alamula can toxic you. That's good. That could be the option. Like, I mean, I thought he was that wide first, but I'm not sure anymore. Yeah, they changed Misty Terrain, but some people still forgot about Misty Terrain. So this could be Calm Mind Tapu Fini. Yeah, I like leftovers. I like knockoff Alamomola. That's the only set I use if I use Alamomola, because Tapu Fini like shuts you down completely with taunt. Like, you can't even toxic that mon if the Misty Terrain runs out. So it will just taunt you. So I just run knockoff, which protects gold most of the time on my Alamomola. But I haven't used Alamomola in a while. Goes hard into Dugtrio. That's interesting, but I don't think Dugtrio beats this one-on-one. Like, Screech with Z-move, I assume. And yeah, he does have, oh my lord, he's probably Z-move. He does have Misty Terrain to avoid the Scald burn. I could see Z-move doing like a lot of damage. But will it Oko or Alamomola? I know Alamomola is piss weak, but Ducky is also frail as fuck, so I don't know if League has like a specific spread with HP investment to take on. Maybe take on HP Ice from Manectric and Scald from Toxapex better? Not sure. They're saying no way Z ground KOs. I don't want to Kulk and miss the turn that he goes for it. I could have called by now. But yeah, looking at League's team. Would he be AV or Fifth Staff Tangrowth? Probably AV Tangrowth. Yeah, he's kinda weak to Tapu Koko. I think it's AV. Because this already showed Screech, so it's not Choice Scarf Dugtrio. So Tapu Koko can always U-turn out on this. I mean, you already let your Dugtrio go down to this low, like, I think you... If you didn't have a Z-move that can kill, I don't really see the point in doing this. And if it's Bedev Alamomola, this might kill. Oh, it was... Oh my god! I can see why that took so long now. He predicted the Protect and went for Rocks, Flex. And now he's gonna go for the Z-ground move and it's gonna do 5 million. Bop the Alamomola. Oh my lord, stop this boy. Yeah, I assume this Alamomola was like mixed defensive with some Bedev, so... That was the only way it could kill, but I wanna run the Kulk real quick. Alomo Mola, minus 2 defense, Earthquake Z move. I mean, this is a different Alomo Mola step rat, but it does 126 to 149. But let's say he's Bolt Max HP, it would still want to do 114. Oh, that's a choice Benedictio, you never mind. I obviously have to get rid of that. Yeah, if it was Fist Dev, it would have done 76 to 90, so this was definitely some dev. So what happened? He switched out into Charizard as the Landorus got up the rocks, and now he Fire Blasted. The Lati gets a crit with Psyshock, which is definitely really annoying, but Lati gets 2-hit KO'd. So Leak is already up 6-4. You can still save the Zard, but Tapu Fini doesn't really defog on much. And Gengar, he doesn't have good Gengar switch-ins anyway. I mean, if it's Choice Gengar, he can predict around it. And Tangrowth, if it's AV, is a fine switch into Shadow Ball. But yeah, just second deductory was probably the correct play. Goes on the Heatran, which makes me think that he might be Scarf Heatran and Fire Blast in the Sun would blow something away here. Because he's either Scarf or he's bulky enough to live a Focus Blast, like one of the two options. Yup, he's Scarf Heatran, blows away the Gengar, but a Cursed Body activates, which sucks. Because the Majina, either the Majina or the Zard gets free set up here. If it's Zardex, that is. Double Dance, Majina with Calm Mind would have been a threat too. Or not Double Dance, but just... I don't think Shifty Majina could have won this game. But yeah, he is probably Zardex, goes for Dragon Dance. And if he has Thunder Punch, he can maybe kill the Tapu Fini here. But it's most likely not gonna kill in one hit. And probably the Tapu Fini has to go for Taunt here. Unless he's offensive with Hydro Pump. Yeah, he can just go for Hydro Pump. As long as he hits, he's fine. He does hit, and there's absolutely nothing. Wow. I thought we'd do a little bit more, so maybe he's not offensive Tapu Fini. They did nothing, what? So he can Dragon Dance again. The Tapu Fini should go for Taunt here. If Hydro Pump only does that little, I probably would have gone for Taunt first. I thought he was offensive Fini. But yeah, Leak did play his Dougie well versus the Alomo Mola early, so I'm not gonna say anything. I mean, like, this is obviously still fine for him. Like, the Zard is taunted now and it's gonna be super low. And the Heatran should be able to take a hit if this doesn't have Earthquake. So it comes. Is the last move Dragon Dance or Earthquake? Oh, he dies to Recall. Never mind. Completely forgot that he didn't have Earthquake with Earthquake. If he had Earthquake, he would have gone for it and killed the Tapu Fini there. Because at 26%, I would have killed. So the last move was probably Dragon Claw. So he just dies to recoil, and yeah, Leak should win this game. Leak lost his first game, was FLCL, uploaded that. If you want to check it out, upload the replay. Damn, that's a long game. A short game. Why did I say long game? Yeah, I haven't eaten today, so. Just woke up 2 hours ago. If my analysis is dog shit, please forgive me. I didn't mean to say that word, good lord, what is wrong with me? But Scarf Heatran is pretty nice. That is HP active, can kill the Landorus, but you probably don't want to lock into that, even if you have it. Because the Majina can potentially set up on that. Even though with AV Tangrowth, if you have AV Tangrowth in the back, I still don't know if it's 100%, but I assume it's going to be AV Tangrowth. With that in the back, you should be fine, or good to go. Where's the Majina is what I meant. But yeah, he does go into Scarf Trend, he's gonna Fire Blast the Majuna here. And if it's a bulky Majuna, like Assault Vest, I was assuming this is Assault Vest, so it can probably live one. Yeah, it eats it up. Yeah, I assume it's Assault Vest, just the way it ate that up. And also, Volt Switch is probably, it's most of the time only when an Assault Vest Majuna. And yeah, you can go into Celesteela here. He sacks off his Zard, he doesn't have any reason to play risky, I guess, yeah. Okay, it's just a defensive land with U-turn. Yeah, he showed rocks earlier, so this game is over. The Celesteela is probably... I assume it's bulky Celesteela because he had Z-move on Dugtrio, but this could also be like Citrus Berry offensive Celesteela. Yeah, it's offensive. It's not Z-move. It's either Citrus Berry or some... Maybe like some boosting item, like... Some plate that boosts his attack, like it's Air Slash. Like Sky Plate. And yeah, Air Slash is gonna pick off the Landers here in Isle of League. Okay, it lived, but Landers can't do anything back to Celesteeland. This game is over. This is a really interesting set. We did not see the item. Like I said, probably Citrus. Like, it's an option for sure. But yeah, this was a short game. Where's my other video at? I uploaded 50% of this FLCL was a snowy game. So yeah, I will upload this game right after. Like an hour after, maybe. And yeah, I'm gonna make a nice thumbnail. And we have Snow vs. Duke Vesper coming up. I'll record that live with my boy Dennis. The game is in about 1 hour. I hope I can... I gotta get some food before that, or it's gonna be bad. But yeah, if he didn't protect with the Alma Mola, this would have been a different game, I think, yeah. Let me calculate quick how much would have... Like, I just want to know how much it would have done. Like, I know he's not that spread. Let's say he was... Maybe he had, like, 100 in defense. If he had 100 in defense, it was a roll to kill. So I assume he... Like, I'm just gonna assume he... Like, his spread is something along those lines, right? Because then it's, like, a mid-roll to kill. So... If he protected on the Z-move... How much does it do again? That's, like, 25%, right? Let me look that up real quick, how Z-moves work. Okay, so Z-moves told me... Google told me Z-moves do 25%, okay. So that means... He would have done a fourth of this. So... I think if I put minus 4, that would be the correct calc. 30 to 35. One second, let me pause and calc that again with my calculator. Okay, so if I calc this correct, 26 is like the... If he gets the max roll, I would have done 26 through protect. I hope I calc this correct. And then... So he would have done 26% to this Alma Mola. Then he would have gone leftovers back, so he would have been at around... High 70 percentages. And how much would a regular earthquake do? I don't think a regular earthquake would kill. A regular earthquake would do 50 to 59. So yeah, this was definitely... This is not the exact Alma Mola spread, but this is about something along those lines as the defense investment he had. So it wouldn't have killed, so League's play was actually really huge, and he won that 50-50. Really well played, and I think there's another game in 7 minutes, I just found out now, so... I'm gonna try to bring you guys that, and thank you for watching, stay tuned for the next game. Dockridge signing out, peace friends.